Okay, come, let's start.
Okay, what up guys? Cyborg here. It's been a long time since I had my turtle coming to the garage. So as usual, here we are with the cleaner and you know it, a 66 speed bike. And it's a major service time for the turtle. It's a 65,000, roughly 65K. So the major things we're going to do today will be VC. My last VC checking the records was actually 2016. So it's been 3 years. So time to do another round of VC check. Change the spark plugs, change the coolant, engine oil, oil filter, service, clean the air filter, check the chain slack, and also lastly the brakes. Brake fluid need to change.
Your last. Okay, then we change the brake.
So we're going to
flush.
Check the brake pads.
Alright.
So the cleaner is going to do all the work while I disturb his ass. Let's get straight to it.
Alright, no worries. Let's start with it. Let me take my challenge first. Okay. We will change. Is that?
See it.
Brake fluid change. Did you bring your brake fluid?
Why I need to bring brake fluid for?
You don't have any extra with you.
Why would I keep brake fluid?
I don't know, maybe something that you pour inside your wine for drinking. Huh?
Touch the screw.
Okay. Done. This is DNA. Never buy BMC product. They're freaking, they will sue me, bro.
No, la, just make sure it's original.
Shit,
la.
No.
Original also like that.
Same. The problem is, on the side wall here, if you buy the BMC product, I'm not saying they are bad. It's good filter. But the bad thing about that good filter is the silicone where they hold this fiber, kan? It's not strong enough to withstand. Fuel punya ni lah, corrosion. So it tends to break brittles. It's become brittles. So it break into small pieces, end up going into your.
How quick does it deteriorate? Do you know? In a
maybe
year,
after
2 years.
3 years.
But it roughly should be time to. I mean, the filter
no,
so shouldn't last forever. So right.
If you see like Canon, the filter is. Not saying the we are not selling brands. Okay, guys, we are not selling brands. We're just giving the comparison, right? So if you see Canon, the filter can stay better. Sometimes it can go up to 10 years ago. After many times you wash it, you clean it, it still can.
So it's worth the investment?
Of course. Okay. It's not really expensive. If you're looking at maybe it's more by $100 only.
Yeah.
But you can clean it often, so the maintenance has to be carry out properly lah.
So for this
products,
one,
everything
for this DNA filter, what's your
the problem
comment?
With this DNA filter, first thing is it's flexible like this.
Okay.
So it doesn't have a hard casing lah. So
okay.
What the intention is to get as much as airflow into the airbox, right?
Okay.
So that's why they build it until to the end. Because if you use the hard one, then you need some space, right?
Mm.
So the air filter punya area becomes small.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is, this is the problem lah. Start to get
crack.
Broken, crack, all this thing.
Still usable?
Still usable, we can wash it. But this is how fucked up is this guy, Jim, using his air filter, you see?
Block lah.
This is Malaysia air quality lah. Jerebu ma. Come on,
please. Okay, so this is before. Let's clean it and see after.
Okay.
Alright. Okay, ne. Expensive shit, bro.
Sure, nah. You bought from Shopee, right?
Yeah. How you know it, bro? Man, Shopee nowadays killing the market, bro. Takde lah.
But the original are not very doubtful, lah. I mean, how do you know?
You can't know.
Especially
any.
The oils and filter they sell.
Yeah. That's why you see now even Liqui Moly they sell it for very cheap. So what Liqui Moly is saying now, if you buy it from Shopee, there is no guarantee if anything happens to your engine. That they just like that. So that is before, let's see how dusty, man. See that? See that? It's getting clean, bro. Yeah. You don't need to even rub it. It's just gonna, see, everything come out. See? Wow. That's how good is the cleaner, man.
Not how good the filter is.
The filter is not good, lah.
Huh? It's supposed the filter to managed to catch what? If the filter
no, the filter supposed is just to allow everything go in, bro.
I thought it's supposed to catch the dirt, what?
Yeah, lah.
What the crap you talking about, lah?
So that the you know your subscriber will be like, what is this guy telling, man?
I need to come and see him.
I need to come and whack him. All right. So let's clean it. It's done.
Okay. Yeah.
Can see,
yeah.
Man. This is how you clean your air filter.
No need pressured air or anything.
No need. Use the correct tool. This is what the result is. You see before and now is the after.
Wow, perfect.
Nice, kan?
Perfect.
See everything. Nothing, bro. Nothing
so
stuck.
At least 10 horsepower, right? Increase.
Normally, if you do cleaning with me, it's 20 lah.
20, yeah. So right now, the filter is being dried. And you are taking off the air box, the air intake unit, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Exposing the throttle body.
This
how's
is
everything?
Your... That's good, bro. Not dirty at all. It's good.
See? So far, so good, huh?
Clean, bro.
So, what do you expect from the VC from the last 3 years ago? Any.
At least I would say half of it. Half of the reading should be off already.
Half of it? Mm. If it's less than half? I mean, if the very minimal of
it's
changes...
It depends on how you ride the bike.
Yeah.
It really depends on how you ride. If you are a aggressive rider, or you are a cruiser, it all depends. But honestly, if you are a aggressive rider, what happens is the engines work differently.
Yep.
So it tends to have more worn. Mm. Right? How you maintain it, that's another thing as well. How you maintain your bike's engine oil. Yeah. But giving said that the way you ride, probably I will expect less than half, bro.
Yeah, I'm a noob rider lah. Mm, I still got my training wheels on, don't worry. Okay, so for the valves?
When we do valve clearance, what we are doing is we are trying to get the clearance as perfectly setting. That's why we do valve clearance, right? So from valve clearance, you get an indication how the valve is doing on your head. You can't physically see how the valve. Is the valve worn out? Is the valve bent? Is the valve have some, you know, pitted? Or you can't see this. The only way to see this is you open the head lah. But we are not opening the head, we are just doing the valve clearance. But the valve clearance will give you indication if the valve has problem. Let's say suddenly the reading is too big, or the reading is suddenly become too small, that's giving you indication. Because we have done this, I think about 30,000 km ago. So now we are doing again another 30,000. So in within 30,000, we are expecting something like maybe 6 or 8 valve going to be within in the tolerance, but most probably to the edge, right? But if let's say suddenly it's out too much, that's giving us like a, you know, like the valve light, like, wait, what is happening down there? Then you have to open and see the head, lah. You have to open and see the valve itself, lah. That's why you do valve clearance, lah. You don't straight away do the top overhaul. You start it with the valve clearance. Even here as well, if let's say customer come and they say, bro, I want to do top overhaul straight away. So we ask, what is your problem? Sometimes they come with the three cylinder condition, alright? And we check. Okay, first what we do is we don't straight away also open the cover cam. We see the compression. The compression is good. All four cylinder, they say, is good. So then what we do? We check the spark plug and realize the spark plug was gone. Sometimes the stick coil, you know, the spark plug coil get gone. So you change that one and it works fine. So it's not really that.
There's a way to troubleshoot.
Troubleshoot lah. You don't straight away jump into lah. You don't just simply jump and then when you open everything and suddenly, oh shit, the problem is still there. And you dah buka semua, dah tukar ni semua, pasang balik. Terus ada problem juga. What you want to answer the customer? Bro, saya dah buat top overhaul lah bro, tapi still jalan 3 silinder. Oh, gagal. So you have to do the proper check now. That's why a proper check will give you what is really happening on your engine.
Are you taking off the whole front section of the bike?
Yeah, I'm taking it off.
Why? For fun?
Because,
you just want to mess with me, mess with my life, right?
Yeah, I just want to make sure that you go back at 10 o'clock today.
10 p.m. I think I'll just spend the night in your office lah. I'll help you jaga tonight. Okay,
the thing is like this. Because we start this recently as well. What we notice is if you don't open up is the head. So when we do the valve clearance, all these, see this, come here, the connectors here, kan? All these connectors here, later when we want to move it, maybe it got some dust or maybe some debris on it, might fall inside your head. So then it's creating a lot of more problems. So what we do is, nowadays is, we remove everything, so this all these wires, connectors, everything will be out, and you have a clear area and much cleaner area to do your valve clearance. Okay. 5 ringgit.
5 ringgit. For?
For doing this shit. It's not shit.
I think you need to pay me 5 ringgit for waiting for you to do this shit.
Thank you. Datang hampir senja, sedang aku. Kau kulur tanganmu membawaku ke atas semula. Last time we change kan?
Last time 3 years ago lah.
Kan? We change kan? From biru dah jadi putih.
Biru dah jadi putih.
Allah eh. You see, ni bila orang main tenis kan? Jatuh je.
Tenis or badminton?
Badminton mana?
The court, they sweat mah.
Oi. Your part is waiting, bro.
Okay, so the coolant, you can reuse, right?
Yeah, can.
Reusable, right? Tastes good, right?
Oh, nice, bro. It tastes like syrup ice.
Syrup ice.
Come on, bro. It was original blue color. Now it's no color at all, bro.
Become water, left water ni lah.
Yeah, it's water already, lah.
Left water ni. After 3 years, so you remove the radiator, you remove the front,
so that when we do the valve clearance now, you see we have a lot of room to work on your valve clearance, and it's much clearer and also much cleaner. Alright, you see that all this apa dia punya wiring, you can put it on the side. It's not like laying on here. So when you open up, so maybe some sand, maybe some, you know, batu-batu kecil itu kan, went inside and make a problem lah.
I see.
So this is much better. This is how we should basically do lah.
But smart also, are you?
You know, this is Ahmad Han, bro.
Beyond my, you over exceeded my expectation. That is your primary job.
You pee here and then you went off.
Yeah.
You do like nothing, eh?
That's what your job is, ma. Your job is to clean, right?
Okay, so kita go angin sikit. Nanti Abang Jah bagi tahu Bagi tarik apa yang ada, saya tengok kalau slot ada masuk bawa main.
Baik bang, baik bang.
Beren ah.
Alright.
Baik, assalamualaikum.
This is for the
maki. Okay. Good, eh?
So spark plugs are out. Can you comment to us?
If you look on the spark plug, eh, looks good lah bro. Maybe this spark plug can save for another 20,000 200,000 km. No lah. So if you look, eh, the spark plug has some like chocolate color kan.
Okay.
So if it brown like this, that means the burning is good.
Okay.
If it dark like this, so probably this we can see from one of the spark plug, eh, this one a little bit dark, right? This is probably got a lot of fuel that goes inside lah.
Okay.
So like this one looks perfect. This is perfect. Honestly, mm-hmm. This is perfect.
So what about the one that's a bit dark?
Maybe the clearance is out. Or maybe the spark plug itself sometimes doesn't burn that good as well lah.
So this.
But anyway, this spark plug can only stay for 30,000. It's good for 30,000. So after that, it just drops. The performance just drops. It's a performance parts, so you expect it to short duration use lah. Yeah.
Okay.
But anyway, it looks good though.
Fresh set of spark plugs there.
Yes.
Same model. Same.
Same thing.
So now after all this is where valve clearance is going to begin.
Yep.
So guys, for valve clearance, if you want to know what is valve clearance, how it's done, you can check out the cleaner's official channel, 66 Speed Bike on YouTube. I'll share the link for sure in the description.
And there is a secret in making sure that your valve clearance is always, I would say, perfect, right? The secret is change your feeler gauge as often as possible.
You mean for the workshop side?
Yeah, of course. As a mechanic, feeler gauge, you have to understand that feeler gauge does worn off. Man, you use it, so maybe after 100 or 200 times, this plate here will worn off easily. And you see that sometimes it bends, right? All this disturb our reading. So like here, this feeler gauge only lasts for 3 months and then we're gonna discard it and buy a new set and use it. And also, you have to make sure that you use a brand that basically produce a very good and accurate feeler gauge, right?
Like so, us, no Shopee brands?
No, I don't recommend that because some China-made brands, they are very, I would say...
Don't equal spec.
Yeah, it's not up to the spec, right? So, we use only one brand, which is Sata. Mm-hmm. Or we use either Yato, these two lah. But mm-hmm. Sata is our, I would say, Obeta. Definitely lah. But Sata is one of the best that I would say give you accurate reading for now. Exhaust. Okay, right. Guys, every single bike has a different WAF clearance reading. Alright, you cannot assume that all the WAF clearance has the same reading. Alright, so for this one is ZS6, so this is the reading. Alright, so what you have here is the clearance. Clearance is something that you get the minus and the plus side. So this is a clearance where your factory set. So what happens is when you do the clearance, the reading should be between 13 to 19. So like this one, we have everything inside the clearance. So that means the intake don't have any problem lah. So the valve seems to be okay. We don't see any much of a difference in the reading. Except we see some reading which is almost going to the edge. So what we're going to do is we're going to replace and we're going to try to put it somewhere in the middle. So this guy can use this bike for maybe another 30,000, you know, without having any problem. So if let's say we maintain this, there is no problem because it's inside the clearance, right? But what happened? Maybe after another 5,000 km or maybe 10,000 km, this reading will be out. So on the next VC when he come, he will see that this number probably has gone down far. So then something that we when we do that time, then we'll see, oh, we expect that we suspect that maybe some wrong with the valve, but basically
maybe to other issues.
Okay. So for now, we just change it so without making any problem lah to the valve, right? So this is the exhaust reading, right? You have 24, right? So the reading is 24 to 31. So this is all okay, except we have one valve here, and we have second valve here. So the reading is like odds, is out from the clearance, but it's not too far. Let's say if you see some numbers, maybe like this one 23, right? Suddenly become 19, or maybe 17. That's triggered something lah. But like this, we see 23, 22. Remember, one of the spark plug was really wet. I suspected it's coming from this or this one lah. We didn't number it. That was the mistake. But anyway, I suspect it's come from one of these lah. Because what happened, the duration has become very big. So the valve, basically the exhaust valve opened quite a lot. So that's created low heat inside the combustion chamber. It could create a rich condition in burning. But anyway, seems to be okay. So we're just gonna proceed with the valve clearance and change the shim, recalculate and redo the arrangement.
Okay, buat kerja.
Okay. You want to show this, right?
So, remember or not, when you come over, you was complaining there was a lot of noise, right?
Okay, yes.
So what happened, this is caused the noise. You see this? It's playing a lot.
Okay.
So what happened is basically your tensioner has not went out to basically give attention to the timing chain. Mm-hmm.
So suppose it's even to move at all.
It should move, but not like this much. This is quite a lot, babe. You see, it's moving a lot. So that's creating the rattling sound inside the engine.
Mm-hmm. Can you do a rattling sound for me? Yeah, so yeah, if you guys, if we forgot to record that, but the sound of the ticking sound of the tensioner wasn't sound like what the cleaner did, that was totally rubbish. But yeah, there was actually a loud, you can hear it's a different sound from the engine.
Yeah, it's basically like rattling, yeah. Bro. It's rattle, because this shit does move like this, la, bro. So it's rattle out.
Okay.
So what we're going to do, we're just going to see the tensioner and see how is the tensioner condition. Mm-hmm. And from there, we see and we will reset it. Mm-hmm. The only way for you to play around with your tensioner is by opening it up and doing like this. A proper way is to measure the tension on your timing chain. Mm-hmm. If you just pull out and take one or two marks out and then put it back, mm-hmm. that's probably gonna damage your timing chain loop. Alright?
Alright.
So this is the way. Alright.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, number 7.
So the tensioner should basically, when your timing chain is too slack, will just go off automatically due to the spring that has set, they will push, right?
Okay.
This spring basically, when you have less tension at the out here, will just basically on. But you see, I put already this spring, it's not coming up. That means your tensioner might have problem, I do. See? I know why.
What happened?
Your spring is not enough. This spring has become soft. It doesn't have the
spring.
Yeah, this spring.
The mechanisms all are okay, but now the spring is weak.
Yes. So I know what to do with this spring. Small modification.
Do I need to get Olin spring? Do I need to put Olin's tensioner spring?
They sell nowadays.
Oh, they sell everything.
Oh, everything now?
On Shopee.
Normally, we just look to the camp and menghayati lah.
Oh, just enjoy the awesome
view of it. So basically, what we have to do when we open up a camp is to look for the sign of the camp being worn out lah.
Worn out.
Worn out, worn out. The word is worn out. See the sign of it worn out. So like this one, if you look, damn, it's very clean, bro. So I don't know what oil you are using, but look like this oil has been doing a very good job in protecting the parts. You can see that there is no sign of excessive wear. This is normal sign. So it looks good, still good. So we can use the cam, don't have any problem. On the exhaust side, it's the same. You don't have a feeling of like, you know, like it's like, oh, macam kasar, eh? Kasar is what? Rough sign. It's very nice, very good condition, all right? So we have to make sure that a good clearance maintain a good camshaft condition. Because if you have very tight clearance, it's also make a problem. Because eventually there won't be you won't have enough oil that goes between the cam and also the bucket, which create heat in the end, which end up will basically have more wear on your camshaft lah. But this one looks okay. The camshaft is very good, very clean, very nice. Okay, no sign of wear or erosion or anything lah. Eh? So looks okay.
So even next
the sprocket is okay lah, bro.
Gigi ya, sehat dan kuat lah.
Nice lah.
Colgate.
Alright. So next we're gonna measure the
shim
and do the calculation and replace it accordingly lah.
Okay. Mathematics, what grade ah?
I just passed SRP, bro.
SRP.
Your time got SRP or not?
No.
Oh, fuck that.
You got the what's that?
I forgot that SRP. I have PMR, UPSR.
Yeah, same lah.
UPSR, PMR, and SPM.
Those pointless exams.
It's been maintained by me, you're fucked up, guy. Let's record what I see. Still taking a shit, man.
They don't know how to buy the shim, so they grind.
Wait, kau jangan record yang benda ni, bro. Kau dah record dah.
Yalah, you
what the fuck is wrong with you, bro? You will be kicked by Rosie fan, bro.
Why?
So what
the
happened
Rosie is... asked you to grind the shim, no, right?
So what happened is, they buy this... Okay, they do a flaren. And they don't change the shim. Instead of changing, what they do is, they grind off this piece. This is what we get from a customer complaining they lose power from their bike. This is what we get. When we open their bike, this is kind of shim that we see. See, this piece even broke, babe. This piece...
So what happened to the other piece that broke? Lost somewhere in the engine lah.
Engine lah.
Shit.
I can't even find it.
How much is the shim? They want to save cost until like that?
Probably 15 to 45, I think. 18, no, no. 20 to 45, okay. Depending on the size.
Tapi tak bagus je. Kalau nak save.
Nah.
Atau sebab parts tu susah nak ambil je. Just don't
nak. Sebab tu, you see my freaking box lah.
Oh, ni banyak.
Kau tengok tak box aku punya banyak? Give a shit, bro! Gang xiang pao ah!
I know already what is it. The newspaper.
Gang yang xiang pao. You don't know ah? The fuck lah, bro?
I thought
it's high. Okay. So is there nice? Over here?
Okay lah, nampak lah tu.
This line, the one at the
behind,
belakang
dia. Behind the tip lah. Okay, flush, kan?
Okay.
And if you go to the exhaust as well, it should be flush from here. From down there. I think you have to take it from here.
Yeah. See or not? Flush.
So finally, after half day, VC is done. Next is checking the leak on the apa tu? Magnet coil side.
Yeah. Inside is wrapped in metal, kan? If not, how you generate electricity?
So the cover is not, but the things inside is binding, like preventing you from cooling.
This is your coil, so we can check the coil also, lah.
How's the coil?
The coil looks okay. Why is leaking? From where is leaking? Looks okay. Yeah, it's leaking from here. See this?
What's that?
See this?
What happened to that?
Probably,
cream.
Cream. It's not cream lah. It's basically you need to put some gasket lah.
Oh, where the wire is.
Yes.
Oh,
it's coming from
okay.
The wire. From there lah. You can see because it's wet over there. Oh, your engine look very clean lah, bro.
Huh?
Your engine look very clean lah.
The cream only.
Seriously? Oh, yeah lah, betul-betul.
Look additive. Jeng-jeng.
Jeng-jeng-jeng. That's why I see the market is there. Siap mana siap? Right. Sip, sip. Fire. This one also for the rectifier.
Kalau ada masalah,
Hey, ambilkan aku WD-40 tu, Lim. Pasang balik. Semua pasang.
Left the brakes lah. Brakes for last. Fluid lah.
Brake last.
Ada mangga kan?
Ada. Siapa dia di sini bangen? Oh, dah? Jangan.
saya bang.
Wajar tu.
Kita balang.
I don't know.
Macha?
No. Huh? I don't think so.
Macha?
Want to do the song?
Ready? Nice or not?
Okay.